When you think of Harry Houdini, you think of shackles, chains, handcuffs, straitjackets. All of those things share one single element, and that is a sense of risk, a sense of genuine danger. And that's why we're here in central China. Now, this construction site will, in about a half a year, be a full-blown city. China is building these entire cities all at once, and they're popping up all over the country. And the reason they're able to come up so fast is because, and this is gonna sound really messed up, is because there is very little concern for human safety in this country. Now that's a bad thing, but it's also a good thing. It's allowing China to do things that would be absolutely impossible anywhere else in the world. By coming here, I am going to be able to reenact one of Houdini's most incredible escapes. It begins with something called the Siberian chain escape. And that is basically a length of chain about that long and an escape from that. And then we'll see where that takes us. Wherever it takes us, what you're about to see is real. It is not edited. There is no camera trickery. There is absolutely no digital effecting going on here. This is as real and as uncontrolled as it happens. And it's only possible because we're here on the other side of the planet. Show me what you found relating to any sort of escape from a trunk. What's this guy right here?
It's called a sub-trunk.
Can you make it bigger? Houdini called it metamorphosis.
Yes.
But I never understood why, because basically the effect is him getting locked into a trunk or his assistant. Does his assistant get locked up?
Both of them, they switch.
What's going on here? He's in a swimming pool?
He's in a swimming pool.
Look at that. Ropes. Let's look into ropes. Hey, Wolf! You think you can get your handle on a bunch of ropes?
Yeah.
Like about 200 feet or 100 meters.
Here's another one to clear.
Here's,
same guy.
Okay, this same guy from Canada? This is Dean Gunderson or somebody else?
Richard Sherry.
Ah, all right.
Richard Sherry, he puts that out. Here's something.
He puts it up. What do you mean?
He makes them and supplies them to magicians.
He sells them to
he
other
sells
magicians.
Them, yes.
So one magician is selling tricks to other magicians. Man, there's a lot of guys doing this, huh?
Yeah.
How many guys are getting out of trunks? That's a lot of trunks out there. Let's see if we can find some drawings of Houdini's original sub-trunk, the original trunk escape. It's perfect, perfect. Look at this. This is great. Where did this come from? Is there more to this?
Oh yeah.
What are these? There's got holes here?
I'm assuming for your
hand holes. Yeah. Can you zoom into this? See if we can find the dimensions on this thing. Hey, Wolf, let's find somebody here. Let's get them these drawings, somebody, a builder. Maybe we also find somebody who does automotive repair, like a car guy or a metal guy. Let's get a price on building one of these boxes here.
It will be done.
It will be done. That's what I want to hear. All right. Look at this. Check it out. Okay. It's okay? Okay. Here. Okay. Here. Okay. Here. Okay. We're pretty good? Okay. Get out. Ta da! Go ahead. Okay, so.
How to get home?
Jump. Ta-da! Here's a key. So, that's for you. You can sell him the key.
Yeah.
He missed an opportunity here. All right. It's all right? Good. Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Yeah! Yeah, oh yeah. So we found a chain. Our translator and coordinator, Wolf, is now trying to negotiate borrowing these chains. The chains were just lying here, nobody cared, but suddenly we're interested in them, so now everybody's interested in them. Can we take them?
Yeah?
Yes. It's okay? It's okay? Okay, thank you. All right, we got chains. The chain has been somehow almost soldered together, so we're trying our best to undo this really hellacious metal rod that is holding the chain in place, and our friends, the construction workers, have disappeared.
Hey. Look at this. Look at this.
They went to.
Ah, shi. Ah, yes. Shi.
Thanks. Yeah, kind of spread it all out in the line. So we're going to take one chain and just hold on to that.
This is ridiculous. You realize, right? It's going to be super easy for you to get out of here.
I don't think so.
I think it's going to be.
All right, fine. All right, Mr. Sweaty Pants.
All right.
Go for it.
Okay.
You do it.
All right.
Lock him up.
There you go.
Spin.
There it is.
We need some music. We'll put it in. Oh, it'll be perfect. It's just falling off, isn't it? This is looking a little bit like this video I've got. I wasn't able to bring it into China, though. There are some laws.
Okay.
All right. Get out of that thing. Go escape. Spellbinding, isn't it? Look at there.
Chain and a bullet aim.
All right. The chain escape crashed and burned, but I feel like I should do something for all these people here that have been hanging out as our audience. So, I know it's not a magic show, but let's do a little bit of magic. Come on over here. Ni hao. Come right here. Ni da minze. Wu Sen Yen. It's Wu Sen Yen. Come on over here. Can I take this? Yeah? Okay. Wu Sen Yen. Watch. Okay. He loves that. There we go. There is the bill. You take that. You take that. Bye, show. So we are at my venue, and I've got word the box has arrived. The guys have actually been here for a couple hours messing around with it already. And this is actually the first time I get to see it. I'm looking at it, and it's not what I expected, actually. Carrie,
yeah.
It's steel. This is a communication breakdown.
On the bright side, they painted it to look like
Yeah, that. That's what this is. Let's close it. So what happened here is I told them to decipher the drawings, because some of it I didn't understand. I kind of left it in their hands. And what we ended up with is a steel box that is painted like wood. Also, it looks like it's got a lot of wear and tear on it. Probably what happened is it's been bounced around on a truck. Do we have any idea where it came from? Doug, did they tell you?
No idea.
Have you messed with it?
Yeah,
let's open it up. Let's see what's inside here. Look at this. They got every little detail, didn't they? Every little thing. Wow, they're good. Let's get the top open. I mean, it looks like it's still pretty sturdy, but then still, it's kind of rickety. Who from our team looked over those drawings? It's safe, right? It's
structurally sound, as far as we know, yeah.
Okay. Zach, jump in there. See what you get. All right, close them up. Let's see how that gets. Okay, try this.
Right.
Zach, so bring your hands out as far as you can, right? That's good. All right, hands together, all the way around. Now, you saw the success we had with the security guard, right? You saw how that went. Let's see if you can do any better. Do not disappoint me, all right? And go. How you doing? Can you get out of there, seriously?
Seriously, you can't.
No way?
No way. My wrists are like...
All right, okay. All right, get him out of there. Tell them we've made a mistake and we forgot shackles to pick up the box. Does he have anything we can use? Will any of this work?
give
what
to the boss.
What about this guy? Can we take a look at this? Can we pull this out? Megan, you can take one in. Okay. Is it equal? We want to make sure it's kind of equal. Find the center, that's really important.
Alex, careful.
Go, underneath. Good. How. Okay, let's do the same thing to the other side. Why is this loose like this?
Oh, man.
What's the deal there? Good. How. Good. Okay. Okay, so Wolf, if you can tell Mr. Crane Man, let's get his crane operating, and we're going to try to hook this with the hook of the crane.
Boom. Boom.
Boom, baby.
So this guy.
Good. Okay, guys, stand back. I don't know what's going to happen here. Stand back. Take it up just a little bit. Little higher. Wolf, be careful. Okay, stop. You know, I don't like this. I don't like this at all. All we've got is the weight of the box to stop these cables from sliding together. And if they do that, then the whole thing tips. This is no way. I saw some steel cable back there. It almost looks like it was designed to pick up something like some sort of piece of heavy machinery or something. So let's try that. What are these used for? What's the normal use? In the States, we have something that's called a rating system. It's rated. That means it's built by a company that has a license and they guarantee that this will not break. Is there anything like this in China? There's nothing. So do we know where they came from?
He also has no idea about
no idea.
We were just jumbling all this stuff in a bag pretty much and just seeing what kind of craps out and stuff, you know.
It's gonna be crap. Yeah. What do you expect? It's built from a bunch of crap that's sitting around this place.
Well, I mean, you saw the state of that box. I mean, like, not, it really did look like
it's not a box. It's a death trap. It looks like they use that for smuggling people across borders or something.
It's hopefully it's not a death trap so we can keep getting our paycheck, you know?
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about.
Think it's good?
I think so.
Dogs, everything feel okay?
Oh, Jesus!
Okay.
So we're trying to shackle this thing up and pick it up again and see what happens. How do you feel about all this?
Sketched out. Beyond belief, especially this jankiness.
I mean, really, are we doing the right thing? We've got a wooden box made out of metal that looks like it's already been through hell. I don't know. You just ask yourself, why are you doing this? What's the point? You've toured the world. Down a pile of TV shows. It's not about the money anymore, so why do all this? I don't know. I guess we do this because this is
That's
what we
good.
Do, you know? While we're doing this, I want to point out that we are shooting this with one camera and one camera only. That's it. That's camera one. That camera has started a moment ago when I was outside the box. It will continue rolling until after the escape has finished. There will be no cuts, there will be no trickery, no special effects, and most importantly, there's just one camera. So you are literally watching it the same as if you were right here, right now, with us in beautiful central China. Okay, I lied. I used a little bit of magic.
All right, I gotta stop doing this stuff.